Club Deluxe, Harlem 1920. 1920 Harlem heavyweight champion Jack Johnson opened Club Deluxe at 142nd Street and Lenox Ave. Not making enough revenue, Johnson sold the club to Oney Madden, a murderer and gangster who took over the club in 1923. Madden's real intentions for the club was to sell his beer. Because of this, the club was closed several times but quickly reopened due to his political connection. The club was decorated to please its entirely white clientele, as in only the upper class of the city. The Cotton Club at first excluded all but whites, yet the entertainers and most of the staff were African American. But getting a job at the Cotton Club was not so easy. Dancers at the Cotton Club were held to strict standards. They had to be at least 5'6", slightly tan, and under 21 years old. Tall, tan, and terrific, they'd say. The club produced much racism, often depicting blacks as savages in jungles and the plantations of the South. White club staff would even tell their greatest musicians, such as Duke Ellington, to keep writing their jungle music for a white audience only. The segregation of the Cotton Club was reinforced by its strong judgment of its African-American employees as savages or plantation residents. The music was often orchestrated to cater to a jungle-like atmosphere. This only made whites believe that these widely held stereotypes of African-Americans were correct. Despite its background of racism, Madden had some of the best jazz musicians in the world play in his club. Ellington Smith, Calloway Fitzgerald, Holiday and Armstrong are just to name a few. Celebrities would crowd the club as their go-to meeting place, especially on Sunday nights. Guest appearances from Jimmy Durante to Mae West and even the NYC mayor, Jimmy Walker, kept the club a most desirable place to go. Great music to great people watching. Sweet.
He gave her things that she was need. He gave her a home built of gold and steel. A diamond car with the platinum wheels. Hadi, 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 hadi,
hadi. Hadi, hadi, hadi,
hadi, hadi. Hadi, 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 hadi.
The Cotton Club was one of the hottest clubs to go to in Manhattan. There were two performances a night, one at midnight and the other at 2 a.m. Despite the fact that few Harlemites could actually afford the Cotton Club, it allowed a new talented generation of black performers to flourish.
She sat around and counted them all a million times.
Although it's said that something so good can only last so long. Strong African-American sentiment flourished the streets of New York. Unemployment was high, police brutality of blacks was a regular occurrence, and extreme poverty left many African-American Harlem families struggling. On March 19, 1935, the race riots reached Harlem. Three people died, 60 were injured, and more than 75 were arrested by the police. The riot caused about $2 million left of damages. The club was forced to close after the 1935 riots because it was considered unsafe for the club's downtown clientele. The Cotton Club at the time was at the heart of Harlem. That is, until 1935, the Harlem race riots moved the club to West 48th Street. Sadly, it never regained its earlier success and closed in 1940. Although its loss of revenue due to the riots, the Cotton Club still to this day remains the largest, most extravagant club in Harlem's history. No one will ever forget the most talented musicians of the 1920s jazz era that the Cotton Club provided.
Is coming to you live from the Cotton Club in Harlem, New York City. And now the Prince of Honey Horns, Cab Calloway, doing Minnie the Moocher.